Hi everyone! Welcome back to IntegralCalc.com. Today we're going to be doing a vertical motion problem. And in this one, we've been given this word problem, which says, you throw a ball straight upward from the ground with an initial velocity of 96 feet per second. And then we've been asked to find out how high the ball rises and how long it remains aloft. We've also been given this formula for the velocity function, which is v of t equals a times t plus v sub zero. And there's several parts to this formula, but the first one is a, which is acceleration. And for this particular problem, we've been told to consider that a is equal to negative 32, which is a constant gravitational force. So because the ball's being thrown up from the ground and it's still fairly close to the ground, we're negating any kind of change in the force that gravity has on the ball. We're just going to call it a constant negative 32, and that's really common in these types of problems. T is our variable, and we'll go ahead and leave that alone. And then V sub zero is the initial velocity, which is the velocity of the ball when it's first thrown from the ground. And we've been told in the problem that that is equal to 96 feet per second. So the first thing we'll do is write an equation using this formula for the velocity function, v of t. So we'll get v of t equals at plus v0. Well, we're going to plug in negative 32 for a. We're going to leave t as the variable, and then we'll be plugging in 96 for the initial velocity since we were given that in the original problem. And just to give us kind of a visual idea of what this looks like, right, we've got, here's the ground, and we've got a ball that's thrown like straight up, and eventually it's going to like reach its maximum point and come back down and hit the ground. So at each of these points, there are three values, and let's mark the points here. We've got the initial point where it's thrown up from the ground, we've got the point at which it reaches its maximum height, and then we have the point at which it hits the ground. Those are the three points that we're interested in. And at each of those three, we know that the ball has a certain height, y, it has a certain time, t, and it has velocity, v. So y equals t equals and v equals, and then down here, y equals t equals and v equals. So there's some things that we can fill in here. We know that the initial velocity is 96 feet, so we can fill in an initial velocity of 96 feet. The initial time, t, is always going to be zero unless they tell you otherwise, but that's kind of the start of time in this problem, right? We only care about the flight of the ball. So that starts when the flight path of the ball starts, time is equal to zero. And we also know that the height is equal to zero because the ball is thrown upward from the ground. So we're calling the ground a height of zero. So the height there is going to be zero. The height's also going to be zero when the ball hits the ground, which makes sense. So those are some things we know right away. We know that we've been asked to find how high the ball rises. So we're going to need the height of the ball, which is going to be this y value here because y represents height. And that's the maximum height of the ball associated with this point right here. And then we've also been asked to find out how long the ball remains aloft. So that means that we need to find this value here, time t, right? Because if we find that, we know how long it's been or what time is when the ball hits the ground, and that will encompass the entire time span that the ball is in the air. So those are the two things we need to find. Well, this path here, this graph, this visual that I've drawn, is represented by the function y of t. Y of t is the position function. With these kinds of problems, they'll often talk about like a particle that moves along the x-axis. If it's moving along the x-axis, right, horizontally like this, in this direction or in the other direction, the position function is modeled by x of t, right, because the change in position is horizontally, it's along the x-axis. But when we have a problem like this, vertical motion, and the ball's moving up or down, in this case both up and then down, the position function is modeled by y of t. So in our case, the position function is going to be modeled by y of t, and that's the function that we need to find in order to solve for the rest of the questions here in our problem. So remember that with these kinds of problems, either x of t or y of t, in this case, y of t is the position function, and velocity, v of t, is the derivative of the position function. If you wanted to know, acceleration is the derivative of the velocity function, but basically this is the order that we're going in. We have up here the velocity function, so we've already got this one. In order to find the position function, instead of taking the derivative and going in this direction, we need to take the integral to go in this direction and find the position function. So we're going to go ahead and say y of t is equal to the integral of the velocity function, which, since we already know the velocity function, is going to be equal to the integral of negative 32t plus 96. So we just need to take the integral of this to find the position function. So taking the integral of negative 32t plus 96, we'll get negative 16t squared plus 96t. And then we have to add c to account for the constant of integration. Now to solve for c, we're going to need an initial condition that involves this position function y. Well, what is the initial position of the ball? We know that, given this information here, since it's thrown straight up from the ground, we know that y of 0, in other words, the height at time 0, is equal to 0, right? So we know that y of 0 is 0. That means we can plug in 0 for t, and we can plug in 0 for y of t and solve for c. So we'll get 0 equals negative 16 times 0 squared plus 96 times 0 plus c. And obviously we'll get 0 and 0, and we'll see that c is in fact equal to 0, which means that our position function y of t will be equal to negative 16 t squared plus 96 t. So that's our position function. Now that we have that, we can easily find y at the maximum height and t when the ball hits the ground. So in order to do that, in order to find the maximum height of the ball, we need to maximize this function here. And the way that we do that is by taking the derivative, setting it equal to 0, and solving for t. So we can take the derivative, we get negative 32t plus 96, which makes sense because that is the velocity function, right? This here is equal to this. We took the derivative, we got the velocity function. When we took the integral of the velocity function, we got the position function, so we just went backwards again. We take the derivative, we set that equal to 0, and now we solve for t by adding negative 32t to both sides, and then dividing both sides by 32, and we see that t is equal to 3. So knowing that t is equal to 3 here, we can now solve for y, and the way that we're going to do that is by plugging 3 into the position function. So y of 3 is going to be equal to negative 16 times 3 squared plus 96 times 3. And when we solve that, y of 3, we get negative 16 times 9, which is negative 144, and then plus 96 times 3, which is 270, and 18, which is 288. So when we add those together, we get a positive 144 feet, and that's going to be right here, 144. So this is the maximum height that the ball attains, right? So that was the first question. How high does the ball rise? That is the maximum height of the ball. Now we need to find the time t when it hits the ground, because that will tell us how long it remains aloft. So in order to do that, we only know here that the height of the height of the ball is equal to zero. So if we set the position function equal to zero, we'll get zero equals negative 16 t squared plus 96 t. We can factor this and then solve for t. So we'll get zero equals negative 16 t. We're going to pull out a negative 16 t, and we'll multiply by t minus 6. So solving this, we can see that t is either going to be equal to 0 or 6. We already know that the height of the ball is 0 at 0, right? This value here is represented by this right here. We know that the height is 0 when t is equal to 0. But we've also found that the height is 0 when t is equal to 6, which means that t is equal to 6 right here, and that's 6 seconds. So those are our two answers to this problem. The ball reaches a maximum height of 144 feet. We know that occurs at time t equals 3. And in terms of how long it remains aloft, we know that it stays in the air for 6 seconds before it hits the ground. So that occurs at time t equals 6 seconds. So that's it. I hope this video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!